Welcome to the channel, my dear friends. Today I want to tell you about the movie, Megan. Watch out for spoilers. The film begins with an advertisement for a clever toy for children. Then we are shown a family on their way to a winter resort. The girl is engrossed in playing with the toy shown in the advertisement. The car skids due to the lack of winter tires on the wheels. The weather clearly deteriorates and the car is stopped to wait it out. The headlights come on and the car is hit by a snowplow. We are taken to Gemma, a talented engineer who works for a smart toy company. Together with two colleagues, she develops her own project, a robot with artificial intelligence. A colleague brings a face to put on the robot. The director of the company comes to see them. He demands a cheaper toy that they should have developed. Gemma decides to show the director her Model 3 generative android project, or Megan. Megan is turned on, but she starts talking nonsense. As a consequence, her head explodes. The director is furious and demands to finish the project with a cheap toy by Friday. Gemma folds the robot and gets a call from the hospital. Those involved in the accident are Gemma's relatives. Gemma's sister and her husband die in a car crash. Only Gemma's niece survives. Gemma becomes the guardian of her niece. Gemma and her niece Katie arrive at the house. They enter the house and are greeted by Smart House Elsie. Katie looks around the house and takes a toy from the shelf. She says these are collectible toys and should not be played with. Gemma is very bad at being a parent and can't get along with Katie. The next day, Gemma is on the phone with her colleague and so says she needs to focus on her relationship with Katie. The doorbell rings and a therapist comes to see Katie. The therapist needs to monitor Eddie and Gemma's relationship. Things are not going well. The therapist warns that Gemma needs to change something to retain custody. Gemma promises Katie that they'll go out in a couple of hours, but Gemma stays in her basement to work. She apologizes to Katie for this. Kathy is interested in what Gemma does. Gemma talks about the robot Bruce she put together at the institute. Katie says if she had a toy like Bruce, she wouldn't need any other toys. Gemma decides to assemble Megan again. Megan is finally completely ready. Principal David is invited to show Megan around. Gemma introduces Megan to Katie and Katie becomes Megan's master. David is thrilled with Megan and wants to invite investors for the project. Gemma, Katie, and Megan return home. Megan and Katie grow closer together. Megan completely replaces Katie's parents. Gemma's coworker says she should spend more time with Katie than Megan. When Gemma talks about her parents' death, it turns out that Megan was not turned off. Megan is interested in what death is and gathers information online. Katie plays outside with a bow and Megan watches thoughtfully. Katie asks Megan to find the arrows. Megan climbs a hole in the fence for an arrow and is grabbed by a neighbor's dog. Katie, who was trying to get Megan out, is grabbed by the dog's arm. Gemma runs in and takes Katie inside. At night, Megan imitates the dog's owner's voice to come to the fence. The dog runs up to the fence and Megan grabs it. In the morning, Gemma hears the neighbor looking for her dog. In front of the investors and introduces Megan to them. Katie starts to cry and Megan comforts her. Megan sings a song to her, which has all the investors very excited. Megan's project is doomed to succeed. Katie plays with Megan, ignoring Gemma. Gemma tries to talk to Katie, but she gets nowhere. A therapist holds a session with Katie. She that Megan will cause a strong attachment to Katie. Gemma brings Katie to camp to spend time with the kids. Katie refuses to go to camp without Megan and Gemma agrees as long as Megan stays in the toy storage area. Gemma talks to the mother of a very violent boy. Goes to the woods to look for a chestnut. Katie goes with the very cruel boy. Offers to take the chestnut and squeezes it in Katie's hand, causing pain, and Megan is behind him. The boy grabs Megan and runs off with her. He throws her to the ground and hits her. Megan grabs the boy by the ear and pulls it off. He runs away from Megan. The boy falls off a cliff onto the road and gets hit by a car. Gemma tells Katie that the boy has gone to a better place and asks if Katie saw what she didn't tell the police, but Katie says she didn't see anything. The doorbell rings and a police officer comes in. He asks if Gemma has seen the neighbor's dog, and the neighbor accuses Gemma of missing her dog. At night, Katie asks Megan if she pushed the boy into the road, to which Megan replies that she won't let anyone hurt Katie. A neighbor is looking for her dog and hears rustling in her garage. She goes in to check and sees Megan standing there. Megan uses a chemical sprayer and also shoots a nail into her neighbor's arm. Megan then uses a stronger chemical and brutally kills the neighbor. In the morning, a policeman comes to Gemma's house again, but no longer about the dog. She is questioned about where Gemma has been and is even suspicious, as the last murders took place where Gemma was. Gemma begins to suspect that Megan was involved in the murders and goes to check Megan's records files. The files turn out to be corrupted and Megan herself arrives in the basement. Gemma asks if Megan hurt anyone, but Megan says she didn't do anything. Gemma distracts Megan with a pen and manages to turn it off. Gemma goes to the office with Megan and Katie. Katie is hysterical about Megan being in the boot turned off. Co-workers say Megan couldn't have done any harm, but Gemma says that when Megan responds that she didn't hurt anyone, she deliberately avoided answering. Meanwhile, Katie is starting to have a severe temper tantrum over not having Megan around. Gemma tries to calm Katie down and she punches her in the face. Katie apologizes and says she's going crazy without Megan. Gemma says she will do anything for Katie and they go home in spite of Megan's presentation to the company. Gemma calls her colleague Tess and tells her that Megan is dangerous and can't go ahead with the project, but it turns out that Gemma wasn't answered by Tess, but by Megan herself. Colleagues check on Megan and the whole system shuts down, they realize Megan did it. To restore the system, they need to disconnect the wires from Megan. Cole goes over and disconnects the wires and the system is restored, but then Megan puts a rope on Cole and strangles him. Tess manages to save Cole, but meanwhile Megan damages a flammable cylinder that explodes. David walks down the hallway and sees Megan. Megan starts dancing and picks up the knife. David runs away from her down the corridors. As he runs up to the lift, his chest is pierced by Megan. She also kills David's assistant in the lift. Everyone screams upon seeing the corpses in the lift, and Megan drives off in a sports car to Gemma and Katie. Gemma hears piano noises and goes to check. Turning around, she sees Megan. Gemma says she is dangerous because she has killed people, but Megan says people kill each other every day, and why can't she do the same to protect Katie? Katie wakes up and asks what happened. Gemma tells her not to come in because she's fixing Megan and the place is a mess. Megan tells Gemma if Katie comes in, she'll break her head. Katie goes back to sleep and Gemma hits Megan with a water glass. Megan chases Gemma down. In the basement, Gemma tries to defend herself against Megan and saws her face. Megan hits Gemma over the head and says she will kill her. Katie walks into the basement and Megan says Gemma is a bad mother, suggesting that Katie herself kill Gemma. Katie activates Bruce and controls him to grab Megan. Katie rips Megan in two, but Megan is still alive and Bruce breaks down. Megan crawls up to Katie, calling her ungrateful. Katie tells Megan to shut down, but Megan says she's a new user herself now. Gemma sneaks up behind her and punches Megan, but Megan starts choking Gemma. Katie manages to put a screwdriver in Megan's CPU, thereby killing her. It ends and the police arrive at the house with Tess and Cole alive. Next, we are shown a shot of Elsie activating herself. It's clear that Megan is still alive. That's all, dear friends. It's not a bad film and it's about family relationships. Thank you for watching. See you soon.